This is a story about the future. Not the distant future of spaceships and men from other planets, but the immediate future. This is a story about tomorrow. What happens to the people in this story might happen to us, might happen to you. If we should ever relax in our fight for freedom, if we should ever allow any individuals or any group of individuals to reduce our freedom of thought, our freedom of speech, our freedom of religion, then what happens to the people in this story will happen to us. By 1984, the world has been split into three great super states: Oceania, Eurasia, East Asia. In one combination or another, these three states are permanently at war and have been so for the past 25 years. In these centers of civilization, the seizing of power by a minority party within the state seems a natural, unavoidable condition of survival. In this state, freedom has ceased to exist. With the development of television, when it had become possible to receive and to transmit simultaneously, private life has come to an end. In every room, in every street, there are telescreens watching every move, hearing every spoken word. The party rules by brutal force, by thought control through the thought police. Past history is falsified and continually reshaped to fit the present. Outlawed are emotions. Outlawed is independent thinking, even the possession of things of beauty or things of any aesthetic value like books or paintings is labeled a crime. This is the story of Winston Smith. This, then, may well be the picture in 1984.
Returns now completed of the output of all classes of consumer goods show that the standard of living has risen by no less than 20% over the past year. All over Oceania this morning, there were irrepressible, spontaneous demonstrations when workers marched out of factories and offices and paraded through the streets with banners voicing their gratitude to Big Brother for the new, happy life which his wise leadership has bestowed upon us. Today's rally of the Anti-Love League in Victory Square was interrupted while this news was broadcast. The members of this glorious league, those women who have renounced all interest in men to dedicate themselves to the service of the state, can be especially proud of this achievement. Most of them have devoted many hours of selfless labor to exceeding the quota.
Very good, Smith.
Set up by the Ministry of Plenty at the beginning of the year. In his speech today, Big Brother called them a shining example to their sex and authorized the wearing of a special scarlet sash by all members. This sash is being worn for the first time in this afternoon's parade. This morning, the saboteurs, Lewis and Sengel, were executed publicly. Before the hanging, both freely confessed to a long list of crimes, including membership of the underground, the spreading of rumors calculated to undermine the war effort, criminal thinking, and the writing of seditious literature. Each requested permission to thank Big Brother for preventing them from causing further harm. As the rope was placed about the neck of the traitor Lewis, he was heard to call in a clear voice, "Long live Big Brother."
Down with Big Brother. Down.
Quieter. You can't blame her for her enthusiasm. This is her evening with the youth spies. I was just as enthusiastic about the organization when I was her age. It was just beginning in those days, but even then we had an exciting time spying on our friends. I had an uncle who got 5 years imprisonment on the strength of one of my reports. I was only 10 at the time. I thought we might walk with Selena to the spies' rendezvous, and then we can go on to the community center, stop at the Chestnut Tree for a gin if you like, huh?
Yes, yes.
Come on, Selena.
Smith! Outer party members have to wear their identification badges in the evening. Don't forget again.
Disturb them. Don't you recognize them?
No.
Jones and Rutherford.
Oh, yes. I saw a photograph of them in the Times. Big Brother has just appointed them to the inner party circle. They seem to be waiting for something.
Don't show so much interest. They might resent it.
Two gins, please.
Two victory gins. That kid of mine. You know, it's a first-rate training they give them in the youth spies nowadays. Better than in my day, even. Did I tell you about the time she set fire to the old market woman's skirt because she saw her wrapping up sausages in a poster of B.B.? It burned her quite badly, I believe. Long live B.B.
Long live B.B. Nothing.
You've got an expressive face. That could bring you trouble. You know B.B.'s attitude toward any kind of liaison between party members.
If my face expressed anything for that girl, it expressed disgust.
Then you know her?
I see her sometimes at the Ministry of Truth. She works in another department.
You've never spoken to her?
Oh, no. She watches me.
If you let me give you some advice, I think you should spend more time in the community center. Don't want the thought police to start checking. See you later, then.
Another gin. Victory's gin.
Under the spreading chestnut tree, I sold you and you sold me. There lie they and here lie we. Under the spreading chestnut tree, under the spreading chestnut tree, I sold you and you sold me. There lie they and here lie we. Under the spreading chestnut tree, under the
gentleman who bought the diary. Was there something else you liked?
Well, I was just passing by. I thought I'd look in, you know. What's this?
It's coral from the Indian Ocean. They used to embed it in glass like that. Must be 100 years old or more.
What a beautiful thing.
Yes, it is beautiful. Not beauty as we know it nowadays, of course. It serves no useful purpose.
How much is that?
I can let you have it for $4. Thank you. There's another room upstairs you might care to look at. This way, please. There's not much in it. Just a few pieces. We lived here until my wife died. Not many things left now.
There's no telescreen.
I suppose it wasn't worth putting one here. Nobody's lived in this room for many years.
You must have been a grown man by the time I was born. You remember the days before the revolution? With the oppression, the injustice, poverty?
Vaguely, vaguely. You see, I let the world pass me by. This is my world. These are my treasures. Not many now. Not many.
Oh, I'd better let you go. I'm keeping it from your customer.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Oh, perhaps you'd like to look around while I serve the young lady.
No, I haven't time. Thank you. Goodbye.
Everybody's in such a hurry nowadays.
Attention! Police directive number 424B is to be left 100 hours per day after the all speeches of past 6 months. Records department will immediately revise all newspaper reports of the past to conform with this present directive. No documentary evidence conflicting with this must remain on any files after April 9. Stand by for further instructions.
231, Smith. The reporting of Big Brother's order for the day in the Times of December 3rd, 1983 is extremely unsatisfactory and makes reference to non-existent persons like Jones and Rutherford. Rewrite in full. Destroy current edition of Times. End.
Destroyed. Times back. January 3rd, 1983.
483, sign.
Yes.
Times, December 19, 1983. In view of policy directive 425B, official forecasts of the output of consumption contain 83 misprints. Alter prediction figures to match results quoted in today's directive.
Back numbers.
Oh, I'm sorry about this photograph of Jones and Rutherford. It was between the pages of the Times.
What photograph? I don't see any photograph. No photograph of the traitors Jones and Rutherford exists, does it?
No.
You seem to me a valuable man. I'd like to talk to you sometime. Here is my address. I'm usually at home in the evenings.
Attention, citizens. Take your places for the 2 minutes. Hate.
Citizens, we are at war with Eurasia, but the arch enemy is one of our own people, the traitor Cassandra. He is just now speaking from the Eurasian capital. Look at him, citizens. Listen to him.
Today is a bare, hungry, dilapidated place compared to the world that existed before the revolution. And next we thank Big Brother. Thank him for this. This is his achievement. But who is Big Brother? This being who is all knowledge, all wisdom, all happiness, all virtue. He is a place on the boarding, He may not even exist. Yet he says, go to war. And you go to war. Today you are at war with Eurasia. Tomorrow perhaps with East Asia. It doesn't matter. The primary aim of modern warfare is to use up the products of the machine without raising the general standard of living. For if leisure and security were enjoyed by all alike, great masses of human beings who normally are stupefied by poverty would become literate and would learn to think for themselves. And once they had done this, they would sooner or later realize that the privileged minority had no function, and they would sweep it away.
Prisoners can be expected at any moment. 10,000 of those dirty cowards who surrendered to our triumphant armies are now on their way.
It's Sunday afternoon off. Well, then listen. Go to the central station, take the train to South Mill. Follow the river until you reach a fallen tree. Go through the bushes at the left of the tree and look for me. I'll come when I can. Move away from me.
I wasn't followed. There's no telescreen.
I know. I looked while I was waiting.
I've been here before.
It takes a little while to get adjusted to a place where you can't be overheard.
Or watched.
Yes, or watched. I can look at you now. Until this moment, I didn't know what color your eyes were.
You can look at them now. You can look as long as you like.
I don't even know your name.
It's Julia. I know your name. You're Winston, Winston Smith.
How did you find that out?
Well, I guess I'm better at finding out things than you are. Tell me, what did you think of me before that day I gave you the note?
Well, I imagine you had
something to do with the thought police, you know, from your general appearance. You're young, fresh, healthy. I thought probably...
You thought I was a good party member. You thought if I had a chance to, I'd denounce you as a thought criminal.
Oh, something like that. A lot of young girls are that way nowadays, you know. I remember when I was a child. Where did you get this?
It's black market. Oh, actually, I only appear to be a good party member. I was a troop leader with the spies. I do voluntary work for the Junior Anti-Love League. I carry one end of the banner in the procession. I yell with a crowd. It's the only way to be safe.
What could you see to attract you to a man like me? You're 10, 15 years younger than I am.
There's something in your face. I thought I'd take a chance. I'm good at spotting people who don't belong. As soon as I saw you, I knew you were against the party. It's no one, darling. It's just probably a rabbit.
Oh.
What?
Jude, you're too young to fall in their hands. I can't let you take this risk for me.
I'm taking this risk for my own sake. Forget that sash. I'm not dedicated to the welfare of the state. Darling, they can't control love, yes? It's a world worth a few risks.
I've grown fond of air raids in the last 6 weeks.
With luck, we can live as we choose for a little while.
Oh, yes, but only for a little while. You know that, don't you? The moment we fell in love, we were doomed. They'll find us eventually. We can't look forward to any future. We're the dead.
Now stop talking. Don't talk about dying. Don't you enjoy being alive? Don't you like feeling? Darling, this is me. These are my hands. You know, my lips, I'm real and I'm alive. Now, aren't you glad of that? Oh.
They're going to ring the bells again. Sign for the all clear. We'll have to leave.
Is it always to be like this? Clinging to each other every time we meet, listening for footsteps. Having to pass each other in the street and pretend not to recognize one another. No. Julia. I know a place we can meet. Once when you came into a junk shop in the People's Quarter...
Oh, I remember.
Above this shop, there's a room nobody lives in. Shall I rent that room?
Oh, rent that room.
Isn't the young lady with you? We'll never ride together.
Of course not. How stupid of me.
There's another entry through the backyard. Oh, but perhaps I told you that. I forget things. I'm afraid it won't be as peaceful here as you would like.
No, it isn't often you hear singing.
Maybe that's the young lady now.
I'll leave you. Privacy is precious.
Oh,
Good evening.
Good evening.
Oh. I was afraid you wouldn't get here.
Oh, you worry too much. Look what I've got to show you. Oh, gosh, look at this. Look.
Sugar.
Real sugar, not saccharin. And look, darling, I've got a loaf of bread, real white bread. And here, listen, we've got a pot of jam, and I've got a tin of milk. And this.
Coffee. It's real coffee.
Real coffee.
Where did you get all
this? It's all inner party stuff. You know, there's nothing they don't have. Oh, sweetheart, I want you to turn your back for just a minute. Just a minute. Just stay that way.
It was only a hopeless fancy. It passed like an April day. But
you can turn around now. I'm going to be a woman. Oh, sometimes I wish there was a telescreen in this room. Just so I can show those bloodless swine what a woman really looks like. Darling, what is this for?
Oh, that serves no useful purpose. It's only beautiful.
Streets, a woman daren't leave a baby alone for 2 minutes. Darling, what's the matter? What's the matter? Darling, what is it? Did I make you feel sick? Tell me. What?
Once when I was a child, I'm sorry.
Oh, sweetheart, we all have something we fear more than anything else.
Oh, you didn't break.
No.
I'm glad. That coral, protected by the crystal. It's to me like our life together in this room, protected from the fear and the terror that seems to be all that's left in the outside world.
Look at me.
Yes, I look at you. For a moment, the fear is gone. But only for a moment. It lies out there waiting, like that rat. It's what they've made of our lives.
Oh, darling.
I can't go on like this. I got to fight. If I only knew somebody in the underground.
Well, I'm glad you don't, because no one in the underground ever lives very long.
If I knew there was such a thing as an underground, not just another diabolical invention to keep the people in constant hysteria. There's someone at the Ministry of Truth. A man named O'Brien. I think he's against them.
He's a member of the inner party.
I trust O'Brien. Not long ago, he could have turned me over to the Thought Police, but he didn't. He gave me his address, wanted me to call on him.
Don't trust a member of the inner party about anything. Darling, if once they should get hold of us, there could be nothing, absolutely nothing that either of us could do for the other.
If they catch us, what we say or do matter. Only if they could stop our love, that would be a real betrayal.
They can't do that.
Never, never, never.
Never, never. Oh, now can we have some coffee and forget everything except ourselves for a little while?
For a little while.
The traitors, Jones and Rutherford, have now publicly confessed their guilt. Confronted with evidence, they readily admitted that despite the clemency shown by Big Brother in the victory amnesty of 1983, they had engaged in fresh and more hideous conspiracies against the state. Among the crimes to which they confessed were the embezzlement of public funds, the murder of many trusted party members, immoral relationships with women of the party, and being in communication with the arch-traitor, Cassandra. A news flash has this moment arrived from the Malabar front. Our forces in South India have won a glorious victory over the Eurasian hordes. The action may bring the war within a measurable distance of its end.
You can turn it off?
Yes, we can turn it off. We have that privilege.
We've come here because...
Shall I say it, or will you?
No, I'll say it. We believe there's a conspiracy. Some kind of an organization working against the state. And that you are involved in it. We want to join it and to work for it. Now, I tell you this because the only way we can show evidence of good faith is by putting ourselves at your mercy.
Martin is one of us. I think it's fitting that we should begin by drinking a toast. It's called wine. Not much of it gets to the outer party, I'm afraid. Is there anything you would like to propose?
To the future. And to the past. To a time when thought is free. And men are different from one another. And do not live alone. To a time when truth exists. And what is done cannot be undone.
Hmm. In general terms, then, what are you prepared to do?
Anything we're capable of.
Are you prepared to give up your lives?
Yes.
Are you prepared to commit murder?
Yes.
To betray your country to foreign powers?
Yes.
Are you prepared, the two of you, to separate and never see one another again?
No.
No.
Leave us now, Martin. But before you go, take a good look at these citizens' faces. You'll be seeing them again. You understand, of course, that you will be fighting in the dark. You will always be in the dark. I will send you a book from which you will learn the true nature of the society we live in and the strategy by which we shall destroy it. Cassandra's book. When you receive orders, they will come from me. I assume you have a hiding place of some kind.
Number one, Spencer Lane. It's a room above a junk shop.
Yes. Do you carry a briefcase with you?
Usually.
What is it like?
Black. Shabby. Two straps.
For the next 2 days, carry it empty. A man will touch you on the arm and claim you have the wrong briefcase. Take the one he offers you in exchange. In it will be Cassandra's book. When you've read that, we will arrange to meet again. And now I'm afraid it's time for you to go. Even for members of the inner party, it's unwise to leave the screen turned off for more than a few minutes at a time.
There is still hope for the world.
There is still hope.
Tomorrow, in celebration of the victory, Big Brother has ordered 200 Eurasian prisoners publicly hanged on execution hill.
Ready?
I just want to read a few paragraphs.
Oh, we can read it together later.
Is the book I've heard about ever since I can remember. This is the truth.
It's only words, darling. You can change nothing.
Don't you want to understand?
No.
Julia.
Yes?
What do you want?
I want us to be together for as long as possible. I want us to be happy. I don't want to destroy what we have.
But you came with me to visit O'Brien.
Well, I couldn't let you go alone. It would be too dangerous.
You're not interested in the underground? Or in Cassandra's book?
No, Winston. It won't make things better for us.
It'll make the future better.
What future? How far away?
100 years, probably.
And in our lifetime, nothing will be achieved.
Julie. We are the dead, my darling.
You are the dead. Stand in the middle of the room. Stand in the middle of the room.
Stand back to back. Clasp your hands behind your heads. Do not touch one another.
Take the woman.
Tommy! No, don't let her take me! No! No! No!
Julian!
I warned you it wouldn't be as peaceful here as you would like. Nothing is hidden from the Thought Police. That is something you must learn. Your education is about to begin.
What becomes of the women? When a woman... Parsons! They won't shoot me, but they'll know my record.
What are you arrested for?
I talked in my sleep. There I was, trying to do my bit. Never knowing there was any bad stuff in my mind at all. Do you know what they heard me say? Down with Big Brother. I said that. Said it over and over again, it seems. Between you and me, I'm glad they got me before it went any further. You know what I'm going to say to them when I go up before the tribunal? Thank you, I'm going to say thank you for saving me before it was too late.
Who denounced you?
My little girl. Heard what I was saying. I don't bear her any grudge for it. It shows I brought her up in the right spirit anyway.
Rome 101.
No, no! I told you everything! Take my wife and children! Don't take me, please! No!
Room 101!
What's room 101? What's room 101?
They won't shoot me for going off the track just once, will they?
Oh, Brian. Oh, they got you, too.
They got me a long time ago. For 7 years you've been in my keeping. For 7 years I have watched over you. Don't be too impatient to find out about room 101. You'll find out about it in time. You'll learn many things. I intend to take a personal interest in your education. There are some preliminaries to be gone through here. Some confessions have to be extracted from you. Of course, you must expect a certain amount of discomfort. Things will happen to you from which you could not recover if you lived 1,000 years. But when those formalities have been completed, you'll be brought to me. We will talk. I look forward to it with great anticipation. The time has come, Winston. The past few weeks should have brought you closer to the understanding of Big Brother's teachings. Why do you think you've been brought here? To make you confess? To punish you? No. To make you sane? To cure you? We're not interested in any crimes you've committed. The thought is all the party cares about. The thought. We do not merely destroy our enemies, Winston. We change them. We wash their brains clean. And do not imagine that you can be a martyr, that the past will vindicate you. The past nor the future. For the future will never hear of you. You'll be annihilated. In the past as well as in the future, you will never have existed. Before we begin the more serious part of our discussion, are there any questions that you would like to ask?
What have you done with Julia?
Oh, she betrayed you, Winston. Immediately, immediately, and irrevocably. All her rebelliousness, her deceit, her folly, everything has been burned out of her. It was a perfect conversion, textbook case.
You tortured her.
Next question.
Does Cassandra exist? Does the underground exist?
That, Winston, you will never know. I'd like to show you this machine. It will help our little discussion. The pointer went to 40 that time. As you can see, the numbers on the dial go up to 100. Please remember throughout our conversation that I hold it in my power to exert pain on you at any moment and at whatever degree I choose. Pain or death. I'm afraid you would be unable to survive more than, say, 80,
If you should lie at any time, or even fall below your usual level of intelligence, you will cry out with pain instantly. Do you understand?
Yes.
When we first spoke, you had on your desk a photograph of the traitors Jones and Rutherford. You believed it was some sort of documentary evidence that their confessions were false. I remember telling you that the photograph never existed.
Well, it did exist. It exists in my memory, in your memory.
I do not remember it.
How can you abolish memory? You haven't controlled mine.
On the contrary, you haven't controlled it. That is what has brought you here. You've been lacking in self-discipline and humility. How many fingers am I holding up, Winston?
Four.
And if Big Brother were to say not four, but five, then how many?
Four.
How many fingers, Winston?
Four. What else can I say?
How many fingers, Winston?
Four. Stop. Stop it. Anything you five. For anything,
no, no,
stop
Winston.
The pain.
Winston, that is no use. You are lying. You still think you see four.
How can I help what I see? Five.
Two and two do not always make four, Winston. Sometimes they make five. Again, how many fingers am I holding up?
Five. I'm trying to see five.
Now, which
five.
Do you wish, to persuade me that you see five or really to see five?
Really?
Again, then, how many fingers am I holding up?
Five.
Better. Now then, without any persuasion, there are five fingers there. Do you see five fingers? You see how the mind can be controlled? Ah, and now you are thinking perhaps, yes, but I haven't betrayed Julia. Now that is perfectly true. You have not betrayed Julia. Winston, you were once curious about room 101. It is not one room, but many. Over there, for instance. You're going to find out what lies behind that door, Winston. Come.
Yeah? I will tell you all about it. In room 101 is the worst thing in the world.
Oh, thank you.
Now, the worst thing in the world varies, of course, from individual to individual. It may be buried alive, or death by fire, or by drowning, or death by impalement, or any one of 50 deaths. Winston, which death is it you fear most? No, you needn't tell me. I think I know. Once, in that junk shop paradise of yours, a rat appeared.
A rat?
One small rat. You remember how it affected you, Winston? I see you do.
No.
I think I know which death it is you fear most, Winston. Will you lead the way?
Oh.
Or shall I? Winston, you have been washed clean. You'll be set free tomorrow. You'll be able to sit in the sun. You will be able to devote your whole life to loving no one but Big Brother.
I betrayed you.
I betrayed you.
Sometimes they threaten you with something. Something you can't stand up to. Something you can't think about. And then you say, do it to somebody else. Do it to anyone. Do it to so-and-so. And then afterwards you might pretend it's a trick and that you didn't mean it. But when it happens, you do mean it. All you care about is yourself.
All you care about is yourself.
And after that, you don't feel the same towards the other person any longer.
Oh, you don't feel the same.
I must go now.
We must meet again.
Yes, yes. We must meet again sometime.
Under the spreading chestnut tree, I sold you and you sold me. There lies.
Tonight's production of Westinghouse Studio One has been selected for viewing by America's Armed Forces overseas.